Hello and welcome back to American Truck Simulator. Where are we? I don't remember. We're in Elko! Oh yeah! The one where we flipped up on the fence. Happy 50th episode, I suppose. Yay? That's about all there is to it. Oh man, $26 a mile from Elko to Oxnard. That fragile and urgent delivery. Woo! What else we got? Could go to Bakersfield. Could go to more Bakersfield. Fresno, San Fran, and it's all lame now. Now we're going for this Elko to Oxnard dealio. Business snooze snatch. I don't know anymore. Let's see if we can get out of here. I think the last one of the times we were here, we got stuck on this thing right here. I'd prefer not to get stuck again. Whoop! Don't crash though. Don't crash. That's also important. Crash like a old Toshiba laptop that was running on like Windows Vista and that was outdated and nobody's gonna get that. Okay, nice reservoir? Is that what we call that? It's not really a lake. Nice quality work. So now it's the 50th episode, we can be like, hey, We've accomplished absolutely nothing, and we should be ashamed of ourselves for wasting over a day of our lives playing and recording this game. But I could say that, or the other possibility is, holy shit, what are we doing? It's really in the same vein, the same conversations coming up there twice. But what the fuck? At least I enjoy it, maybe. Who knows at this point? Why do we do this? Why has God put us on Earth to play American Truck Simulator over and over again? This is fucking torture. Not really. I like it. Shut up. This is crazy. Okay. Anyway, how's your day? Happy Monday or Tuesday or Wednesday or Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and so on. Happy day. Happy days. Oh God. Now haven't we had this conversation recently? Jeez. It's always hitting the same old notes. Excuse me, truck. Thank you. Look at that bitch. Has a bigger truck than us and carries shorter cargo. Pussy. Because he doesn't know what the true truck thug life is. Does anybody? This guy doesn't know either. He's driving my truck and he doesn't even have cargo. We don't either at this current moment. I'm sure he's on his way to make a delivery. So we're all just out here trying to make a living. Bakery. It's a bakery. Oh no. Oh no. It's a red light. Good stop. We're just in the middle lane. It's fine. There is no middle lane. I am the middle lane. The middle lane appears and disappears around me because I am some sort of break in the time dimension. I don't know. I couldn't think of anything. Oh jeez. Oh darn. Nice Hood's Supermarket. Hood's is not a good name for a supermarket. Hey bro, you wanna go down to Hood's and get some snacks? Man, I don't know what the fuck you would go to. Where's the cop? Whatever. We've got 90K, we can fucking burn it in front of the police and be happy. Isn't that what y'all just wanna do with our money? You that's the point, right? You save up your money just so you can burn it in front of other people? That's what I thought. Isn't there a hole back there? Couldn't I totally just drive in there and run over those pedestrians? Oh, fuck you. It was turning right. I hate you. God damn. Red light. Beep, beep, motherfucker. Uh-oh. That's a wall. Funk. We could really use a service. And hopefully not being dead afterwards. And just a good old drive. Excuse me. Oh, my eyes. I've destroyed them. Not really. Oh, God. Well, my entire family has glasses. I have glasses now. Just not very intense glasses. But, you know, it's the life. At some point, I'm going to have to wear them in the future. It's crazy. Our eyes. How can our eyes be real if our eyes aren't real? You feel me? Okay, let's... Do we really have long cargo again? Man, we can never catch a fucking break. Sometimes you just want short cargo so you can make a turn easier. It makes life easier. Just saying, like, why not the one on the left here instead of the one on the right, huh? You want to deliver goods in an urgent manner? What did I run over? That's confusing. A pebble? Is that what I hit? It was just a random rock in the fucking road that was like, no! No, you don't get to move. It's like fucking Arma 3 rocks at that point. How dare you run over me? I'm a fucking landmine rock now. It's like, wow. You decided to blow me up because I was in a box truck driving 25 miles an hour down the road when a sudden pebble got under my wheel, cracked the fucking windshield of the car behind me. The car behind me sped up, swerved in front of me, and flew me off a cliff. Yeah, logic. Except it cuts out everything else and it just decides to kill you anyway. Woo! Although it's better than the ATVs in Arma 2 when you would drive them near anywhere near a railroad track and all of a sudden they would flip into the fucking sky. Like, that doesn't seem very smart. But they did it anyway. Every time you try to drive an ATV over a fucking railroad track, no. No, you will get shot up into the sky. It's the fucking Russian rocket program now. You're the first fucking human into the stratosphere. Or something, even though they had many successful space missions. Ooh. Alright, what's up? For sale shopping center. 20 acre site. Oh my god. 20 acres. Look at that. 20 acres, Kappa. What is that, like a fucking my backyard? Jeez. Just kidding. Okay, we're... Fuck you. Hood Supermarket. That's all it is? Fresh and tasty grocery, 24 hours open. Now you're just sounding like Walmart. Are Walmarts? Oh, shit. I would assume there's gotta be some Walmarts that are open 24/7, right? Do they exist? I don't know. Oh, excuse me. Thank you. I don't know of any. There could be. It seems like something they would do. Get that grocery at 2 a.m.? I don't know. Maybe they don't. Is Walmart one of those companies that's open 24/7, 365? I wouldn't know, you know. Fuck your holidays, bitch. This is America. What a wide variety. You get, like, people in government jobs, they get, like, President's Day and shit off, and it's like, wow, that's becoming a little more unique at this point. Not that many people get those national holidays off, like fucking... No, Labor Day and Memorial Day are kind of special, but like MLK Day, is that a national holiday? Maybe? I think so. Martin Luther King Jr. Day or whatever. Or just Martin Luther Day, that'd be weird. Let's celebrate the Protestantism. That wouldn't be a thing. Alright, where are we headed? We're headed down back to Oxnard, right? Through our good old Winnemucca and our favorite rest stop of all time. How can we avoid that at all costs? Should we go a different direction? Just because my hatred for it is unreasonable? We could just go south here through Tonopah and whatnot and just make a quicker turn. Well, how much longer would this take? This is, what, 709 miles? Jeez. What if we cut down through Tonopah? It's 800 miles. Holy fuck. That's a lot of driving, but honestly, I think I'm going to do it. Just see a little bit of different sights. Because I'm tired. I'm weary. These old bones have seen a lot of driving. Office space for lease? What office? What, do you have to fucking work in the goddamn... Knoll caves? I couldn't think of anything there either, so I for some reason decided to go with a fictional creature. Knolls, though, those are weird motherfuckers. Fun fact. Alright. We need to get service, because we can't hit top speed right now. This is a disaster. We can go like 60 miles per hour, it's just not working out. Where is the nearest... Oh shit, we have to get turning. Where is the nearest? It's in Tonopah. Okay. Fun times. When we all, oh, whoa, did you see that for a second? We like went straight through the ceiling. Oh. Whoa. Whoop. That couldn't get it to work again. That was freaky. Yo, what's up with this bumblebee truck behind us? That ain't cool. That shit's a little racist, honestly. Silly Transformers. Never saw any of those movies. Because, fuck it. Oh, excuse me. What is this thing? We haven't seen one of you in a while. Is that an ambulance that's just been stripped of its ambulance duties? There's, you know how there's like, I wouldn't call them like stripped down, but police cars that have been unpolicified and become available for like civilian purchase and use in transportation? You know, so it's just a police car that doesn't have the police stuff on it. Please get up this hill. Oh, come on, don't fucking stop again. Anyway, so would there be some like an ambulance that you could drive that's been unambulantified? Whoop whoop. I mean, I wouldn't doubt it. That'd be a weird thing to drive, for sure. What do you... It'd be some sort of weird fucking van. Oh, boy, we're not gonna make it. Come on. Come on, you can do it. I believe cargo. Don't hit that truck. Thank you. Alright, now we're on the open road. Again. Hold up. Way. Back on the road again. Some, back on the road again. Anyway, I don't remember that song. I don't remember anything about the song except back on the road again. We're born to be wild, I know that for sure. Hi, son. You're a son. You're the only, my only sunshine. The skies are my something gray when you're something about being sunny lighting up my life. Can't remember any song right now. Jeez. How am I supposed to make my dank references when I can't remember any songs? Boy, what songs do I remember? None. None at all. What's the last song I listened to? I think it was a Thomas the Tank Engine remix. So that's interesting. God, Thomas the Tank Engine. What a amazing subculture. I think it's a little weird. But it's unique, that's for sure. Thomas the Tank Engine. They're just trying to blaze it with Thomas the Tank Engine. I don't quite get it. Oh, it's those damn parachuters again. You know what? Fuck you, bitch. Mac that shit. Keep it 300. Ugh. Don't. I love our sunroof, though. At least it gives me something else to look at. When did we get our new truck? Like episode 30 or something? I mean, what, like another 10 episodes we should have another truck? Is that our metric? Every 30 episodes you get a new truck? God, that sounds like a nightmare. Even though I'm pretty sure the first 30 episodes constituted less time than the next 30. We should probably have another truck soon. Is all I'm trying to say. Unless we're just mad because we're bad. And then we can hire a new driver and it can all be a good thing. Fucking Jeremy Irons in the classic movie Dungeons and Dragons. That was really bad, but really funny. Yeah. We of course want to stop for a nap, stop for gas. That old song and fucking dance that we've been through 100 times already in the past. Did that rhyme? That might have been the dopest rap that we've ever gonna come up with. Where do all these people live? Because there's three camping vans. There's that shed by the water thing. There's a the same motel. It's all Dave's motel. Daisis? Is that Daisis Hotel? Motel? Oasis. Oh my god, I can't read. Hotel. Motel. Holiday Inn. If your girl starts acting up, then you take her friend. That seems really rude still. Maybe you want to communicate instead of just immediately packing up your things when everybody acting a fool. Okay, can we get out of here? Can we also successfully get gas without crashing? Because I remember we've had some problems here in the past. With life. You know what? I can't be bothered to make that sharpest turn of all time into that gas station. No, we're gonna go and head and... Is that a car wash? Can we get car washes? That'd be weird. Anyway, we're gonna go ahead and just get gas in Tonopah when we get serviced down there. That seems smarter. Avoiding death is preferable, as we've talked about. A dead man can't hold your hand, and then... I can't think of anything that rhymes with hand. My mind is really bad at putting the puzzle together right now. Hand. Band. So a dead man can't hold your hand, and what we were supposed to turn there. Oh boy, this is sad. Alright, let's make an illegal U-turn in the middle of a highway as a semi-truck with a lot of cargo, because how could that go wrong? And especially at 11 p.m. at night. You know, I have a lot of respect when you see truckers out at, like, midnight and shit, man. It's like, wow. You getting the job done, I feel you. Maybe you prefer driving at nighttime, less traffic. A little bit harder to see, but what's the problem when there's no traffic? You definitely should be, if you're up in the Midwest, you gotta look out for those deer. That's a large problem. I know a lot of people that have run into a deer in the past. You know, it totals your car, it may or may not kill the deer. If the deer don't give a shit is the answer, okay? Deers, moose, large mammals that don't really want to beat the shit out of you, but will beat the shit out of you if given the opportunity or wanting. If don't fuck with nature is all I'm trying to say. They will fuck you shit up. They will fuck your shit up so hard, and then you'll be like, oh shit, that moose just fucking cracked my windshield. Now our car's totaled because it like fucked up the engine too, and now we got to get a tow. Now it's like 2 a.m. because I was driving at night, and now it's all a disaster. I have not hit a deer, thankfully. That's always something to look out for, though. You see them, sometimes you're driving along on the edge, or on a highway. Maybe not the full-blown like interstates around cities, but even though you get out a little more from the cities, you get along some woods. So it's like you're driving down maybe like a four-lane highway, two lanes each side. You've got woods on both sides, and then you've got like your wildlife in there. They're all wanting to cross the road, but they can't cross the road. They don't have a fucking stoplight. They just gotta book it when they think there's no danger to them. But hey, who knows when that is? You know, get that deer in the headlights. Look, they stop. They make weird decisions. It's crazy. You know, I've also seen like bears on the side of in those woods doing that in the past. And you get your bears. I haven't seen a moose. Moose don't really live this far south too much. Just crazy stuff. Have you seen any moose? It was a weird conversation my friend had while canoeing down a river. Some dude was just on the side of the river like, have you seen any moose? I was like, what? Okay. Anyway, and then you got that, and then you got the random hunters that are on the side of the highway. I saw those. They were hunting like fucking turkeys or deer or some shit, man. That was interesting. Crazy, crazy hunts, man. You know, in places like Hawaii, they've got an ecosystem that's built on an island, so, you know, there's not a lot of comings and goings, a lot of, like, interchange of species, so, you know, they don't allow things like snakes onto the island, of course, because that would fuck everything up, seriously. But, you know, that also creates a lot of problems, so, you know, like, things that have been induced as whatever it's called, invasive species, that's it, and they gotta go on sort of a culling every now and then. So I think for a while it would just like, on this day or night, you can't go outside after a certain time, like 10 p.m., because they'd all go get fucking night vision goggles and like fucking bows and guns and go hunt shit all over the island. I was like, wow, that's manly. Also, because bow hunting on an island in the hilly volcanic island seems pretty fucking tough, but hey, they did it. I got respect for bow hunting, man. That doesn't seem like easy shit. Gun hunting, you know, not easy either, but like bow hunting, holy fuck, you gotta be a fucking accurate motherfucker with a bow, and then you gotta be the diligent one to chase it down, because I doubt you would have a higher chance of killing an animal on your first try with a bow as you would a gun. Probably got to do a bit of hunting. You got to put it out of its misery. That's the proper etiquette. Crazy. Hmm. What lovely desert we have here. Whoa. I really don't like desert. You know, I just give me some lakes, some trees, a good mix of coniferous deciduous trees. Oh man, I love it. Whee! That was fun. That was the most fun turn we're ever gonna have in this drive. What's my favorite road in this game? I don't know, is the answer. You might be asking, you wouldn't be asking, but you might be, theoretically. Why, what is your favorite road? And I couldn't tell you. Because they all look the same to me and they've all blurred together at this point. There are those couple of roads in like southern Nevada that have those weird roller coaster hills that are just like quick up and downs. Those are kind of fun. They bring a little bit of variety, I suppose. But everything else, if you got your standard highway in the California area that runs north south, and that's about it. Speed limit of 55, slow down, speed up. Traffic out here, you just got your high speed limits, but a lot of turns, not a lot of traffic. And a lot of desert, and it's like, well, who's the real winner? I don't know. What's the population of Nevada? I assume Las Vegas and like Reno have a fair bit, but like LA, like compared to fucking California, LA has like some like 12, 13 million people in the metropolitan area, and then you got the Bay Area, which is another few million, of course, so, you know, and just that general Southern California. Northern California, I don't know any major cities up there, but I'm sure it has a fair amount of people. Oh, God. He's a man. Okay. Check both ways. We can go on the right. Can we go on the left? We're doing it. I'm scared. Stop the truck. Thank you, bro. I feel you. Well, that's awkward. I stopped looking right and he came. Oh, no. Oh, what a disaster. Okie dokie. Anyway, let's hit up the service station and the gas station. Yeah, we're having engine malfunctions. It's so bad. Ooh, okay. We can hopefully not do that again. Hey, it might happen again. Turn right. Nice church. I love hedges. I'm just saying, like, a nice hedge. It could be in the shape of an animal. Those are cool, too, but, like, hedges? They're like fences, except beautiful and nature-y. You feel me? They give me a fucking wrought iron fence, and I was like, well, it's just a fence. It's just a metal fucking fence. It's like, well, that's okay, I suppose, but then hedges? Hedges, at least, make it a little more natural. It doesn't feel like it's so gated in. Oh, please. Whoa, that's not good. Okay. We're fucked here. We are very, very fucked here. How do we fix this situation? Cry. What we do is we go around. We go in a big circle here. So we're gonna come up to this red light. We're gonna take a left. We're gonna go get serviced. We're gonna get gas on this way, and then we're gonna leave this the way we just are coming now, and it'll all work out in the end. See, look at this fucking geometry. The math skills to pay them. I really just want to go through this red light, man. There's okay. Well, we've had the decision made for us, so fuck you. Woo. Do we want to sleep? I don't think we need to sleep. We already slept. Slip. Do we have time to do this? Well, that's interesting that we only have 11 hours and 37 minutes to finish this job, and a little over that in terms of time to get there. I forgot about the urgent delivery part when I made the decision to come this direction. Hopefully it'll all work out in the end. We may have to do a little bit of speeding, that's for sure. A little bit of red light running, we can make up the time, I believe. We also gotta get through this part. This part is gonna be a little bit time consuming because we aren't making any progress and we only have so much time. Time. Time's not on our side. That's all I'm saying. We gotta race the, we gotta race the clock and our own idiocy. We've got a lot to compete against. Incompetency, idiocy, failures of being a mother. Please excuse me, fence. I'm just trying to leave. Let me in. Open 24 hours. I mean, well, that wouldn't that suck? It was just like, well, it's open from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. and our technicians will show up sometime between the hours of 9 a.m. and 6 p.m. Fuck you, Comcast. Not that I just don't like the, maybe Comcast doesn't have the best customer service. You know, get this Google Fiber up in Minneapolis, that'd be fantastic, but that's probably not gonna happen. Too bad. Beautiful service that I think Google Fiber is providing. At least creating some competition. Get us better internet service. I love a good internet service, man. If you can download at fucking fiber optic speeds, oh, that'd be amazing. You know, dealing with shit internet in remote places such as Hawaii again. You know, they gotta fucking run a series of tubes and wires through the goddamn bottom of the ocean, so it's not like their internet's all that good. Honestly, so hey, buddy, it's a pain. It's truly a pain there. But at least here we've got we're living in the continental United States or whatever. It's nice. Okay, we gotta make up time. We got 11 hours, 45 minutes. 11 hours, 30 minutes. We gotta make up 15 minutes, and we might be able to make that. Excuse me. You're impeding my progress, and I'd appreciate it if you'd speed the fuck up. So I'm gonna pass you either way, because you are not obeying the laws of me. The laws of me. Sounds like a fucking... the title of my autobiography. The laws of me. Oh. Silly autobiographies. And biographies. How many biographies are out there? Do people still write biographies and autobiographies? I assume people write autobiographies, but do people still write biographies of new people? Not to be like new people, but not historical figures. Of course people would write biographies about previous events because they're dead and can't write their own autobiography, but like, would fucking like Lil Wayne write an autobiography? Sure, I could believe it. Oh shit, we did it again, man. We fucking did it again. Alright, U-turn. Quick U-turn. We got this. Nice town? I don't know if that's what you would call it, but it's a location that has people and buildings. Call it a fucking western hoodiggy. Hoodiggy. You wanna stop at the hoodiggy for the sup up? Let's go. 420 miles. Ayo, 11 hours to completion. I'm really worried about our time. Ooh, we've only got 10.5 hours. I think we lost some time there. That's unfortunate, but we got this. We gotta speed up. We just gotta go a little bit faster, harder, better, faster, stronger. That don't kill me. It only makes us stronger. I need you. Some. Give me a little some. Maybe that'll speed us up a little some. Maybe holding down the W key harder will help, right? Maybe if we lean forward and maybe we go burr, 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 I'm a race car. Maybe that'll speed us up. Unlikely to have an impact, but hey, you know, everything's worth a try, am I right? But do we take damage on the trailer? Whatever. It happened, apparently. I'm worried that we might, going this fast, we might compromise our safety going around some of these sharper turns here, like this one, because they are, they're not the easiest to go, at least, especially going full speed, because it gets a little scary. Ooh, we maybe swerve off the road a little bit, we maybe get a little into a ditch, and then maybe that'll ruin us, ruin our lives, ruin our family, ruin our self-esteem, because it can be hard, I assume, to have a high self-esteem if you maybe disfigured in some sort of way. I don't know, man. I'm beautiful. I'm always beautiful. You can fight me. The laws of me. Let's keep it going. It's okay. It's so slow. Mario. Mario, and Luigi Mario. The Super Mario Brothers movie can go fuck itself, is all I'm saying. Clearly the last name of Mario would not be Mario. Mario, Mario, and Luigi Mario. Seriously, what the shit? Also, like... Isn't... What's... Bird? Bird lady. The Yoshi who's a woman is also like a man or something? Like, some sort of cross-dressing plot in one of the older games? Super Mario games? I'm just saying. The Yoshi with like a ribbon. Or whatever the fuck, and pink spots or some shit. Man, I don't remember the name. When's the last time I've even dealt with that shit? Like fucking Super Mario Brothers? Smash? Brawl? Melee? Dick fuck the dong smasher. What do we got? I'm just gonna make a quick update. We're in time. We're within time right now. We're within the rules and regulations of basketball, of the National Basketball Association. Do people still watch arena football? I don't remember the acronym for it. Oh yeah, here's the hills I was talking about, sort of. Woo! Up and down, baby. Up and down. But do people still watch arena football? I don't know, man. I saw it a couple times just because, like, this is weirdly strange. Have you ever wanted to see the weird violence of hockey where people check each other onto walls? And the sport of football, American football? No? Not necessarily. I don't know. Is it more intense? How long has it been going? Is it still going? Crazy. Absolutely insane. You're insane. In the it should stop, really. Oh, goodness. Look at that. Sick. What are those called? Like, I wouldn't call them a handlebar. Hold thing. You put your hand around it to form a grip, and then you hold on to it to get in and out, maybe for safety reasons, maybe to you know, in most of my cars throughout my life, you can like hang dry cleaning on that. That's some reasonable for it. Even I think some even have like hooks for putting your dry cleaning on or some shit. You know, gotta hang it up. Gotta transport it though in your car, you feel me? But that one, of course, is sideways, so it'd be a little difficult. I also don't know why you'd be transporting your dry cleaning in a semi-truck. That maybe not be the optimal vehicle for that operation. We are just crashing into the other semi-truck that was in this lane, because this hill was sharper than I thought. We took a lot of damage on our trailer there, unfortunately. 4%, you know, that's gonna cut down on our money gain in the end. And we started with like 90k. We're already down 10k, so I had another like 4k on top of that. And really, we're gonna profit like a little bit of money. Well, though, I think it was only like 5 grand of loans, so maybe we lost only like $5,000-$6,000 so far. Subtract that from the 19,000, that's 13,000 profit, minus whatever the fuck damage we're gonna take by the end of this. Or who knows, maybe we're gonna run like 8 other red lights and speed 20 million times, and really it's just gonna be a disaster. A natural disaster, such as a tornado, earthquake, tsunami, of course, and whatnot. Maybe it was a disaster like the movie Twister, the early 1990s film. Wasn't that like the first film on DVD or some shit? I thought I heard that fun fact, which kind of made me a little sad, because that movie is hot shit. The fucking tornado roars, man. The tornado roars is all I'm saying. Why in horror movies you gotta make things that don't roar? You get Jaws, that doesn't roar. Snakes and anacondas don't roar. Tornadoes don't roar, that's for sure. The Metal Gear Solid robot, I suppose, roars, but that's a little silly, too. Why does it roar? Fucking Metal Gear. Metal Gear. Because why not put a bomb in some lady's uterus? You know, you feel me? What a weird scene that popped up in. I wasn't expecting it. Some callback to a previous video game. I was like, what the fuck are you on about, game? It's like, oh, you're alive? What, you had a bomb in you? There's another bomb. Let me fist her. What? That was a weird cutscene. I'm just saying. Woo! Did you like it? Let's book it. Faster. Why'd you stop? You think you scared? You scared I'm gonna crash into you? I would be too. You see some maniac driving down the middle of a road, going like 20 miles over the speed limit. It might be time just to hide in the cornfield. Of course, you're not protected by the corn, but hey, I don't know. And you're also probably gonna get killed by the scarecrow ghosts that inhabit that cornfield. But at least you'll be safer than the crazy drivers. And this is awkward. Yeah, we were never gonna make that turn. Now we're on top of some rocks and shit. How much damage do we have taken? Oh, okay, we didn't take too much damage there. Just a little bit of time penalty. What is this, crazy taxi? It doesn't matter how long it takes, as long as we get it done in the allotted time. What is this, Need for Speed? What is this? Grand Theft Auto? What is this? What is it? Another one. What are those? No, we gotta stop. We're memeing too hard. Look at those beautiful power lines, isn't it? In it. I've lost my mind. We've only got 168 miles to go. Hey, baby. Oi. Oi, Atsula. Oi. I just wanted to know what was up with all the gondola pilots. Is that what you call a boat driver? A captain? Gondola captains? I don't know if a gondola is a big enough vessel to be called a captain. But you know the gondola boats in... You sail around canals such as Venice. They all went oi to each other all the time. Oi, 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 oi. Pass one another, oi. And that was a weird experience. Woo! Okay, what's up? What's up with you? I wanna know what's up with you. With your life. How's your day going? How's your week going? How's the fam? Chill fam. Silly Vin Diesel. I don't know why I thought Vin Diesel goes with chill fam, but now it does. Because that is a... Wow! Look at that police officer just passing me up. You want to fucking go? I'll speed to pass you. And then you're going to give me a ticket and fight me. There's that video on the good old YouTubes. It's like a police officer pulls over some woman for speeding. And the woman's like, I thought you didn't give pretty girls speeding. And then the cop goes like, oh, you're right. So here's sign here. And I was like, oh, shit. Unexpected thug life. What a great subreddit unexpected thug life is, though. That's a good time. Just because it's pretty funny. You never expected it in some things. Oh. There's some good ones. That's all I'm trying to say. Doesn't matter if it's an animal. Doesn't matter if it's a kid. Doesn't matter if it's a grown man who knows exactly what it's doing. It's always kind of funny. And then you throw in the Dr. Dre, Snoop Dogg, even occasionally like other artists. Woo! Hi, bus. That was close. And yeah, you throw in that music in the end and a silly little Thug Life logo, and boom, boom, you've got fucking gold. The only sad thing is like. 10% of the videos are deleted from YouTube for copyright content, so... Whoops. Good luck. We don't need to stop for anything, right? We can't sleep. We don't have time to sleep. We gotta make this fucking delivery now. Right meow. Are you kidding me, right meow? You gotta be kidding me, right meow. Okay. We take a left here, supposedly. Alright. That's okay, we're fine with taking levs. All you have to do is hold the A key. That'll turn the steering wheel, of course. Maybe you want to hit S to brake before you run a red light. That's always important. There we go, we're slowed down. We're parked. We can let it all go. We can scratch our head. We can stretch our fingers. We can cry in the corner. We can think about how we have all the mistakes we've made during our drive. We can inspect our dry cleaning. I'm just thinking of all the stuff you can do with the red light. You can check your phone theoretically. May not be the safest or smartest idea, but hey, it's a thing you could theoretically do. I'm not endorsing texting and driving or any phone usage that could cause a dangerous situation for you and the other drivers on the road. I guess we get another red light. Hey, that's just our luck, isn't it? We've only got so much time to make a delivery. Fuck you. This is something I've noticed over the course of the game. Time seems to slow down in urban areas. So, you know, you get out in the highway, everybody's driving faster, time seems to speed up. You know, like right now, we should have had like 5 minutes pass already if we were on the highway. But it's still 10:05 a.m. And it'll stay 10:05, now it's 10:06 a.m. But it seems to slow down in urban areas. I don't know why that is. Maybe they want to give you the time to drive safely in towns without having it seem like you're spending hours and hours waiting on traffic lights in towns. That'd be a little silly, of course, but I don't know. I don't know. It's just a weird change. I don't know how it's calculated, how anything happens, really. I don't know. How does magnets work? How is Babby formed? It's just the questions of the ages. Okay, we're crossing the highway. What's up, Thuglot? Brick Squad? Oh, what are you doing? What are you doing, truck? You can see me coming. He pulled a me and pulled out into traffic like a true thug, though. Everybody's learning. Doesn't make the road safer. It just makes everybody happier. Me, and I'm the only one living in this world. This world full of crazy Google cars that have lost their fucking mind. And I'm here to navigate this life of despair. I don't know what that was. Can somebody tell me what the hell I just did? Because I couldn't tell you. Nice view of the highway here. Ooh, looking fine, everybody. Woo! Okay, that was a tough one. Is that a hot dog? It is a hot dog. Man, why do they think we love hot dogs so much? Woo! Hot dogs. They're just sketchy meat in buns. You know what else I could put a meat in a bun? Hey! Hamburgers. Buns. You can put hamburgers in buns, so you get it, but you could also maybe put, this is awkward. Excuse me. I'm so sorry. Please let me through. I'm so sorry, Garden. Don't do me like this. Oh, fuck you. Why can't you just go over the curb? It's like 2 feet high. Oh my god. Oh, back it up. Back it up, bitch. Let me see it. Back it up. Drop it down. Pick it back up. I don't remember the words to Snoop Dogg and Little John's magnum opus, whatever the hell that one's called. Grab that dick, it's yours, bitch. Back that shit, it's yours, bitch. Now grind up something about making his dick bigger, because with your grind up on with your booty, and you know that can cause maybe a blood to flow in a certain direction involving a man's phallic tool set. Let's just finish this fucking delivery before we all go mad. I assume we don't have that much further to go if we only hit 57 miles. Do we still have time? We still have time. It might be a close one, but we had time all along. See, not even that car can stop me. I was looking at the GPS. You know, you shouldn't use technology to distract you. Not at all. Okay, back at it again with the stupid noises. Just because I want to be Frankenstein, does that make me a bad person? Maybe. I don't want to be Dr. Frankenstein, of course, you know, don't want to make that confusion. I want to be the monster. I want to have that confusion where I just want to be friends, but the town hates me, and we took another loan installment. Really? I don't think we made any money at this point, with loan installments included, because, woo, we've certainly lost money at this point. We've lost 20 grand over the 2 days we spent driving this mission. Holy shit, what a disaster. We're not even gonna make it up because we have a little bit of damage on the trailer. Well, I'd say this drive has gone exceptionally, fantastically garbage. Trubbish, you could say. Roses are red, Charmander's are red, Squirtle's are blue. Trubbish is garbage, just like you, I think is how it goes. Some to that effect. Trubbish is, of course, a Pokemon that's apparently a little literal piece of trash. Human feces. No, it's actually just garbage. No, Garbodor is the evolved form of Trubbish, I'll have you know. Trubbish is just trash. Garbodor is garbage. But he's like a dumpster garbage. It's weird. So many weird Pokemon that just, like, aren't animals. They're just things, like the fucking ice cream cone. And I don't even know what Octillery is. It's like some sort of demented fucking octopus squid that's also a goddamn cannon. And it just doesn't make a lot of sense. I feel bad for that poor demented creature. He's tormented. Same with the fucking ice cream cone, man. It's just a goddamn piece of fucking ice cream in a cone. And you expect him to live like that? Some scientist out in the world of Pokemon has fucking somehow made these abominations and let them loose into the world. And now they're just trying to catch them for enjoyment. It's some sick shit. Somebody's got to call the ACLU. The Pokemon's rights are being destroyed. Goodness. Okay, sorry, I'm in a hurry. Skip. Reasonable is all we got there. Minus 4 grand for a total of 15,300. 912 XP is not bad, though. And what are we up to? 87 grand. So we really didn't make any money off that. Maybe even lost a little bit, but that's okay. Because we're ready for the next mission. We're ready for the next episode. Smoke weed every day. That's a song by Dr. Dre, Snoop Dogg, featuring Corrupt and Nate Dogg. You know, fun times. Anyway, thank you for watching this episode of American Truck Simulator, and I will see you next time. Have a good one.